What we're going to do in this lecture is to create a macro that's going to copy data from different tabs into a summary tab. This video is brought to you by Unlock Excel VBA and Macros course, where you're going to learn how to simplify your work and how to save time by automating complex and routine tasks. We're going to go from beginner all the way to advanced. For more information, check out the description of this video or go to xelplus.com/courses. Find out more about the course at the end of this video. Here, the concept of absolute versus relative recording becomes really important. Now, the thing is that it can also become your biggest headache if it's not done properly. So I'm going to demonstrate what each of these does on their own, so how absolute recording behaves and then how relative recording behaves, and then we're going to see how we could use a mix of the two to create dynamic macros. So let's go to our summary data tab. We already have some data on this tab. What we want to do with our macro is to automatically go and fetch data from this new data number one tab, so this one, and then paste it on the bottom of this data set. We want it then to go to this other, the number two tab, copy this and paste it on the bottom of this updated data set. So the challenge here is to find the next available row. Now the toggle where you can turn relative referencing on and off is inside the developer tab. And we can see it right here underneath record macro. We generally record our macros in absolute mode, but there are times that you want to turn it on. To turn it on, you just have to click on it. And then when it gets this dark gray background, you know that it's on. And then when you click on it again, you go back into absolute recording. So now let's try this. Let's first have it off and try to find the next available row on this data set. And then we're going to turn it on and then record the same macro and see the differences between the two. Okay, so I'm going to click here on the bottom and create a new macro. The first one is the absolute recording. Okay, so my toggle is off. Now I'm going to bring up the Visual Basic Editor so we can see it record while we're recording. So Alt F11. Now the code that's here is what we worked on in the previous lectures. Our new macro must be recording right here. Yeah, that's the absolute recording. Okay, so what I'm going to do is to collapse this and just snap my windows into place so that we can see better. Okay, so first I'm going to click on the header. Now I can see it recording. It says range A3.select. Now I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut key control arrow down to jump to the bottom of this data set. Again, I can see it recording that as well. Now I'm going to move one cell down. Okay, now it says range A9.select. So it's fixed the cell reference to A9. Now let's see the difference when we record in relative mode. So I'm going to stop this. I'm going to click where I was before. And let's turn on relative referencing. And let's record the new macro. Okay, so again, I'm going to click here. Now notice it recorded this movement differently. It used active cell, so active cell is where I was on, and then it's using the offset property. So this is something that we're going to learn in more detail later on, but just so that you can understand this code, the first argument in offset is the number of rows it should move, and the second one is the number of columns, right? So it did -1 because it moved here, and then -1. It moved one up. The last argument is actually something that the macro recorder records, but it's not something that you need. And it can be very confusing because wherever you are, it always references to range A1. But just take this as meaning it's one cell, right? If I would change like A1 to A2, it would then highlight two cells. Okay, and it's something that you don't need. So you could, after you finish recording your macro, you could just remove that reference. Okay, so now I'm going to do the same movement. I'm going to do control arrow down. Okay, that part of it is identical to the way it recorded in absolute mode as well. Now I'm going to move one extra cell. Okay, so you did active cell, that's where I was on last, and then it offset it by one row, zero columns, and one cell, okay, which is what I have. So this one looks better than the first one. So let me just stop the recording from here and let's test which one works better. I'm going to copy just this here so that we get more data. Now let's go back to where we were. So I was here and I'm going to run that first macro. So we can run it from macros here, but since I'm already in Visual Basic, I'm just going to click inside the code and run the first version. Okay, I end up at A9. Now I'm going to go back here and then click on the second version and I'm going to run this. I end up on the right cell. So this looks like it's the solution to our challenge. But what if we are right here and we click on this? What do we get? We run into a problem. Why? Because the first statement, if I press debug, we can see the problem is from here. It's trying to offset this by minus one and minus one. And then it's going to jump down by wherever this is. So it's going to give us a problem here. It's going to give us a problem if we're not in the right place. So if I do this, it's going to give us a problem as well because it's going to jump to the last cell in Excel here. And then it can't offset anymore down. So it's not going to do what we wanted to do. I'm just going to do Control up to get back up here. So it seems like the best combination of the two would be what? That we use the absolute referencing here. For the second line of code, it doesn't matter if we have switched or not. And the third line of code, we need to be in relative referencing mode. Okay, so let's now try to record the macro that we want that's going to copy data from these two tabs in here. I'm just going to remove this part that we practiced on and let's turn off relative referencing. Okay, so we're going to start with absolute. I'm going to click on this button to record a macro and call it copy data. Okay, so first we need to move on to the tab that we want to copy. The first one is the number one tab. I'm going to click here. That's where my data starts. So Control Shift down, Control Shift right. And remember, these ones, it didn't matter if you were in absolute or relative recording, but the fact that we want to start from A4, that's important, right? That's something we need to fix. So I'm going to copy this, Control C, go to Summary Data tab. Now I'm going to click here and let me switch this to single procedure view so that we can see it better. And now I'm going to jump down. Okay, right here I need to switch to relative referencing. So I'm going to turn on this toggle and go one down. I'm going to immediately turn it off because I do tend to forget to turn this one off. And I'm going to paste this. Okay, we're still not done because we want to copy data from the second tab as well. So now I'm going to go back here. Click on this, Control Shift down, Control Shift right, Control C, go back to Summary Data, go back to the top, Control down, toggle on right now, one down, paste, toggle off, and then I'm going to click on A3 just to come to the top of the data set. Okay, and I can see it recording all these steps here. Where are the offset ones? They are right here and right here. Let's not forget to turn off that recording. It seems like it's working. Let's test this. Let me create a button for it as well. It belongs to copy data. And let's also call it copy data over. And let's just test this by deleting some of this data set. I think this one starts from F. So let's just remove all of these. I'm going to close the Visual Basic editor, open this one up, and click on copy data. Okay, I can see it all coming up here. So until 29, let me click on copy data again. It should copy them again below this. Okay, So that's how you can use a combination of absolute and relative recording to create dynamic macros.